Hello everyone, this is Krishna Gupta and welcome to the lecture series on Human-Computer Interaction. In previous lecture, I have discussed about Norman's 7 principles. Now in this lecture, I am talking about Nelson's heuristics 10 principles. So let us start the Nelson's 10 principles. We know that our brain performs shortcut to solve the problems and this process is called heuristics evaluation. And this is the simple thinking and this is the brain. And so the brain performs shortcut to solve problems and judgments in short time without constantly stopping to think about their next action. So this is the process of heuristics. Simply we have a problem and create a shortcut in our mind and get the solution. This is the final process. And this mental simplifying process is called heuristics. And next we start the 10 principles. First principle is visibility. Visibility is what? The system should always inform the user about what happening. In other words, all action need instant feedback to guide you. Example is there. You have used a mobile and there we have pattern lock or we can say password system. If password or pattern is wrong, show the red color, and password and pattern is right, then show the green color. In this case, you can't be logging your mobile. In this case, you can be logging your mobile. And then second principle is real world. Real world is what? Relationship between interface and real world. Example is there. If you want to like on Facebook, you want to like a image, you want to like a video, there we have some more options like bow, angry, etc. So this is the complete process of real world. And then we have rule number 3, and principle number 3 is freedom and control of the user. Now freedom and control of the user is, example is, if you are using mobile when you have opened multiple application or windows, so make easy the emergency exit for the user. Allow undo or redo action in the system. If you have WhatsApp, Facebook, Snapchat, Telegram, you can close from them one by one or you can clear all. So this is the freedom. And then principle number 4 is consistency. Consistency is what? Consistency speak the same language all the time and never identify one action with icon or different words. Example is phone call and on off system. Phone ringing, you want to pick a call, green symbol. If you reject the call, you have red option. Simply answer and reject. And icon from them, you can choose. If you want to pick a call, you simply click on answer or drag from the upper side or left side. And reject, you can move your finger according to the reject system. And then on off system, you simply click on or off and choose one from them. Then we have principle number 5, error prevention. Prevention of mistakes or error. Prevention says that such as a deletion or request may be accomplished by a confirmation message before the user confirm the action. Example is there. If you play the game, are you sure you want to exit? This is the first option. If you want to exit, click on yes. If can't, you cannot be exit, you click on no. Would you like to save your progress? If you want to save your progress, you click on yes. If you not interested in save the process, you click on no. And then principle number 6. Principle number 6 is recognition rather than recall. The next is recognition, allowing the interface to offer content, sensitive help and information capable of guiding the user's action, that is dialogue system with the user. And we have simple WhatsApp example, there is chat, status and calls. These all icons have different tasks or actions. You click one by one, you can see in WhatsApp window. And then principle number 7 is flexibility. Flexibility and efficiency of use the system must be easy for lay user, but flexible enough to advanced users. If you search something on a Google, example is like blog photos. You want to search, and these blog photos show on a window. There we have menu bar. This is the menu bar of photo blog, and you can found or choose your demand or easily recognize what you search and what is in your front. There we have home, gallery, and design. There we have different tasks to perform. And then rule number 8 is minimal dialog box of Gmail. So it design avoid text and design that talk more than you need to know. The dialog system must be simple. Example is there. If you use a Gmail, if you are using Gmail, then you click on Gmail dialog and system. So it is very simple, as we know Google, like map, YouTube, Drive, photos, etc. There we have so many options with a Gmail, more in the end. Then we have rule number 9, and rule number 9 or principle number 9 is error handling. Error handling is what help user recognize dialogue and recover from errors. It help to recognize and repair errors. Example is there. Simply you want to log in. There we have user ID and password. Simple login your Google account. If user ID incorrect, show red, then fill or correct it. It is a intimation from the Gmail side or other side. And last principle is documentation. Help and documentation is contact list in our phone. We want to call, then you select a number from the calling list. So that's all about the Nelson's 10 principles. Thanks for watching, and please share with all. And you can download my complete notes, link given in description. Thanks for watching.